Hey YouTubers, this is Cameron Prepper here. Hope you're doing very well today. For the ones that don't know, yesterday that Russia were firing hundreds and hundreds of missiles into Ukraine, and two conveniently landed in Poland, killing two people. Whether this is a deliberate act or by accident, no one knows yet. Investigations are underway. Russia are always denying it, obviously. That's what Russia do. They do deny things like that. But NATO do the same as well. So they're just as bad as each other. Everybody sort of flies the false flag, so to speak. So we'll soon see what happens in the next few days. We do expect, obviously, Poland to declare Article 4. Which gets all NATO members into a meeting to discuss what's going on. Now, depending on what they find in this investigation, it depends on what NATO's next steps will be. I think the NATO, I have written, so I think that they did say that they would defend every inch of NATO soil a few weeks back. So we will sort of see if they actually mean that in itself. Whether it was an accident or not. It could be a way of Russia sort of poking at the another superpower to see how they react as well. So we don't know how it's all going to plan out, really. If it comes back as Russia have deliberately fired two missiles into Poland, obviously Poland at the moment are heightened alert now. They've got the military ready. Even more so now than before. So would they go to war with Russia without the aid of NATO? Even if Article 5 is a thing, would everybody agree to go to it? Could it be it's all those things. If all NATO countries don't agree, and a couple do, could it be the first fracture of NATO where you see them disbanded? No one knows what's going to happen yet. But one thing we are for certain, obviously, the tensions now have gone up even more. So we have to keep an eye on the news and try and take out as much as you can, really. So it's just worrying times at the moment. So, yeah, what can NATO do if they don't declare, obviously, all that war with Russia? Hopefully that doesn't happen. But you never know. So I think the next steps they could end, obviously, the first step, obviously, they could enter the war, keep it on just to sort of flush out the Russians from Ukraine and keep it as that, as like a conventional war, no nuclear war or anything like that, just to flush them out of Ukraine itself and push them back into Russia. That's one aspect they could do. Another aspect, they could provide air support to Ukraine itself. The Ukrainians have been asking for that for many months now, so they could provide that. Another aspect, they're obviously more funding they could for Ukraine as well, to assist on them, to help against fighting the Russians. They receive billions every time, but obviously more funding to fight obviously would be beneficial to them. So those are like the aspects, obviously. Either way, if a war does take place, it's going to be costly for everyone. Obviously, it's costing a lot of lives of Ukrainians at the moment, and it's going to cost even more people's lives as well. And I don't think no one truly wants a big war. And it's sad to see that what's happening in Ukraine it's emotional to see, and it's quite sad to see, and it shouldn't be happening. In this time, especially when a country wants to be free from their former oppressors. This is nothing against, again, I mentioned this in my previous videos, in terms of Russia, this is nothing against Russian people. I truly believe this is a Putin war, a government war, rather than a people's war. I've met some fine Russian people, and there's nothing wrong with them. It's this, the government that they are, they run under and controlled under. At the moment, obviously, we notice that China and India have sort of pulled away from Russia. They've gone a little bit more quieter with Russia. Could the NATO see that as a sign of weakness? Could they exploit that and attack whilst Russia are losing the allies? Possibility. So is this the waiting game now? Is this trying to live your day, trying to live your life as best as you can, but whilst preparing for the worst? I'm only going to do a short video just to try and get an ideas on what you think of what's this happened in Poland with the two missiles. Do you think it's deliberate or by accident? Do you think they were trying to poke a hole in NATO just to see how they respond? I just want to see what your thoughts are and what's happened yesterday. So hope you have a good day. Until I see you again, this is Camera Prepper out.